Hi, Jagan here from TechTutor. So as a follow-up video, here I would like to explain some Docker basic commands, right? So that's what we're going to be seeing here in this video. So if you still want to know, understand about the differences between dual booting, multi-booting, and then the containerization or the virtual machine, so maybe you should watch my other video, right? So in this video, I'm just going to focus only on the Docker hands-on, right? So this is my Mac laptop. I have not installed the Mac, Docker on this. So what I have is I have this VMware Fusion, which is a hypervisor. On this, I have installed CentOS. Okay. So I will log into my CentOS machine. On my CentOS machine, I have already installed Docker. Maybe I'll try to log in as root user, and let's check what is the version of Docker I have. As I recorded this video, Docker 1903 community edition happens to be the latest version available. Okay, so you can see this. Then if you wanted to check the images, Docker images present in the system, so you have to issue this command called Docker images. So you can see that these are the Docker images I have. These are the Docker image names. And these are some of the versions of these images available. And then what for Docker, what matters is actually these names are for human beings, right? And whereas for Docker, for every image, it assigns a unique image ID, right? So these are the images available in my local Docker registry. And then you can see the sizes of these images are listed here. And then if you are interested in seeing the currently running containers, you will issue this command called Docker PS. Okay, so this is how things work here. Now, just to give some idea, right? So again, just to explain and understand some background information about how Docker works. So this is, this thing we have not discussed in the previous video. So I thought like I'll first explain this, then move on to the hands-on. Okay, so Docker is a client server technology, right? Okay, so now you have your Docker client. Have your Docker client. Then you have the Docker engine here, which happens to be a Docker daemon, background service in Linux, or it could be a service in case of Windows. Now, if suppose this happens to be the client happens to be local to the same machine, both the Docker engine, which is a client, and the server, if they happens to run on the same machine, then the communication between the client software and the server software happens via local Unix socket. So basically, whenever you start the Docker engine service, whenever you boot your system, as part of the boot up, your Docker engine service also, the daemon also gets started. Okay, so the Docker engine then starts a Unix socket. So the Unix socket is used by the Docker local client to communicate, request for some services and so on. Okay, that is a way. That is the way these two software components are going to work. Now, on the machine, wherever the Docker server or the engine is running, it also creates something called as local registry. Okay, this is a Docker local registry. So this registry is going to contain all the locally cached Docker images, right? It may have many images. Okay. Now, if suppose the image that you are trying to look for, images like Docker images, nothing but just like you have VMware image, or in case of you have this ISO images, operating system images, generally you download the DVD ISO image or the CD ISO images, ISO images, right? So similar to that, this is the Docker image is a specification of a container. So whatever software you want pre-installed on your container, so you would generally install all that on the image level, and you create an image, you burn an image. And with that image, you can create as many containers as you want. So in short, Docker image is nothing but a blueprint of your container. Now, if so, you are trying to create a container which is of Ubuntu image, then Docker, through Docker client command, I mean, maybe you will issue something like this, Docker run hyphen it, then you will say Ubuntu, maybe 1604, then you will say bin bash. When you say this, here, this is the Docker client we are talking about. This is a Docker client. Okay, this run command will create a container, and then it will start the container. This IT stands for interactive terminal, right? So this is the image name, Ubuntu, right? This is the Docker image. And this is the tag, version, or version of Ubuntu image, right? So this is the utility or the program that you would want to run. This is the application or utility or shell that runs on this container. Okay, so now this is a client. So now this client software, what it will do, whenever you issue this command, this client software is going to write this request into the Docker, that is Unix, local Unix socket. So the Docker engine then will receive that request, and then it will go and look for this Ubuntu image onto this local registry. If suppose this local registry doesn't have that, then it goes to something called as Docker Hub, which is the remote registry, right? Docker Hub. So this Docker Hub is going to have all the open source Docker images. So then what happens from here, this will be downloaded, or in other words, it will be pulled from the Docker Hub, and then it's going to cache it here. So end of the day, whenever you're trying to create a new container, that particular container image must be there in your local registry, right? So that's how things work. Okay, hope this gives a basic idea about what is the Docker client, what is the Docker engine, and then what is the local registry, what is the, remote registry or the Docker Hub, all that, right? Okay, so now I'm going to minimize this, and then I'm going to move on to the hands-on part. Okay, so we saw the Docker images. These are the images present in my local registry. Okay, so if you need, further images, like, let's say you're looking for some Hello World image. So maybe what you could do using Docker, you can say Docker pull Hello World. This is the image coming from Docker Hub, right? So there is a website from where you can actually pull all these images. So it is getting downloaded from the Docker Hub, and now this is present in my local registry. So if I say Docker images, now I can also see that it has downloaded this particular Hello World image, which was not there earlier. Okay, so now if at all I wanted to create a new container of this Hello World, what I would do, I would use this command Docker run Hello World. So now this is going to create a container and run this container like this. This is the output coming from that container, right? So if I wanted to see this container, usually you use this command Docker PS. But this particular container, what it has happened is, this image is not doesn't contain any blocking application. This application is not going to run forever. So that is why what happened is, after the container was created, and then once it has printed the output, looks like this container has terminated, exited. Okay, so if at all you wanted to see this container running, maybe we can use something like Ubuntu image. Maybe I'll use Ubuntu 1604, and then I will say bin bash. Okay, so as I don't have this particular Ubuntu 1604 image on my local registry, so what Docker is right now doing is, it is pulling those image, this Ubuntu 1604 image from the Docker Hub into my local registry. And you are seeing some 3-4 downloads that is going on. In fact, the images, Docker images, are further broken down into image layers. And those are the 4 layers you are seeing that is getting downloaded. And the number of image layers that depends on that varies from one image to the other image, right? Okay, so once the download is done, you this I mean where it is saving all this, I mean these layers and the images, they are getting saved into the local Docker registry, right? So meanwhile, what I'll do, I'll show you how the Docker Hub looks like while the download is still going on. I'll like to open my Chrome browser, and then maybe I'll just hub.docker.com. This is the website. So this is where your, all the Docker images can be found, right? The open source Docker images, community-based images can be found. And you may also go for, in case you are looking for enterprise edition, so maybe you should go for enterprise hub where you find all the certified images and so on. Right, so you can see if I click on explore, so I will get a list of Docker images available. So this is how you can actually download the images based on your needs. I mean, you can download whichever you want from this Docker Hub to the local registry. Okay, so hope this still download is still going on. Okay, maybe we'll explore until then. Maybe I'll try to create a new window. In that window, so what I'll do, I will say this sudo su hyphen, and then I'll say docker info. So this docker info command, what this is going to do, this is going to give information about, some detailed information about our Docker installation itself. The version of it, you can see the server version is this, and what is the storage driver it is using. And if you further scroll down, you can see this important information, which is a Docker root directory. So this is where, the image local registry is all created, varlib Docker. So just in case you are curious, you could actually go to varlib Docker. You can see this is where all the images are actually maintained, right? So if I go to the image folder, you see this overlay too. And then you can see there is a file called repositories. If you see the repository.json, it has all these image information. So for instance, I can see this is one of the image, one of the Kubernetes image that I'm using on my machine. You can see Calico network interface related images present, and like that. I mean, you should be able to find the other images that I downloaded, right? So basically you can see now Ubuntu 16.04 is also there. Right. Okay. So now if you further go into this image DB, you will see this content. Yeah. You can see some list of files here. Let me open another tab here. In the other tab, sudo su hyphen docker images. Okay. Now I can see Ubuntu. I should see somewhere. Yeah, I can see Ubuntu, which is 125 MB, right? Definitely, this is not a full-fledged operating system. This is just a container, right? So it has the application, maybe the shell that comes with Ubuntu, and a few tools like package manager and things like that. But it doesn't contain a kernel, right? So kernel still depends on this CentOS operating system. So on the CentOS operating system, there is Linux kernel, right? The Linux kernel is just common for all the Linux operating systems. Whether it is a CentOS distribution or Ubuntu, it is all common. So this Ubuntu container is going to make use of this, Linux kernel that comes with CentOS, right? So they are all same. It's like different cars using same engine, right? So you have this, maybe you have Audi car or RD car, and then you have Volkswagen, cars. And though they look like different, the engine is used. Used are basically the Volkswagen or the Volkswagen engine. So similar to that, the engine here, the synonymous is basically the Linux kernel. But the distributions, they give a feel that you are working on a totally different operating system. But it is just a distribution, right? So they distribute their favorite tools along with the Linux kernel. That's all. But bottom line, it's all Linux. Okay, so now we have downloaded this image. And if you see, we have already created a container, Did you notice that this shell has changed from root to this one? So that is because we are inside the container now. If I say hostname hyphen I can see the IP address of this container, right? Whereas if I say ifconfig of this machine, NS33 is the network interface name, here I can see this is a different IP address, whereas this container has got a different IP address. So this is why people compare, they try to compare a container with a operating system or a virtual machine. But in reality, it is just a process. What you're seeing is just a process, but it seems to have its own file system, all that. And this file systems comes from Docker images, which is very interesting. Actually, it's a lot in a very big way. It is very, very lightweight, right? So it's, I mean, if you see the overhead, the memory requirement for a container is very, very less compared to your your virtual machine, because the virtual machine requires its own dedicated hardware resources, whereas the containers doesn't require its own dedicated hardware, because it is going to share the hardware available on for your on your host operating system. Whatever RAM, whatever CPUs and the storage is available in the host machine, that is being shared by all the containers running on top of that kernel, right? So that's how this works. So maybe if I say Docker PS now, I can see this container, right? So you can see the container, currently running container. Okay, so this is the container ID. Just like we saw unique name assigned for every, unique ID assigned for every image, now this is a unique ID assigned for the container. And this container is created out of this Ubuntu 1604 image. And yeah, so now you can see it full. And this is the application or the bash shell that is running inside. So then when this was created, and then this is up till what time. Since we have not given any name for the container, this is a random name assigned by Docker. So in case you don't like this name, you may rename this to maybe Ubuntu 1, right, whatever it is. So you can say Docker PS, now you can see this container is named as Ubuntu 1, right? That's how this works. Docker is actually a very big topic as such. You would be able to create your own custom image. You have like concepts like port forwarding, networking, pretty much whatever you do with typical on-premise server or virtual machines, pretty much you can do it here as well. But however, one thing you have to understand, Docker is still one process, right? So within one container, ideally you should run only one application. If you try to install many applications into Docker container, then what Docker does is it uses something called a supervisor D. So this process will, I mean, if you create two or more applications within one image, so what happens, it uses a utility called supervisor D, and the supervisor D will create two or three other process, each process for one of your application, and then the supervisor D will monitor all the processes status. So it's all overhead. So it also defeats the purpose of container. Container is supposed to be independent, right? So it's like as tiny as possible. So whenever you're trying to create microservice in a cluster, so you really don't know, or you don't know where your application is going to run. It can be deployed in worker node 1 or 2 or 3 on the Kubernetes. So whenever one node dies, or one node dies, maybe like these new pods or containers will be created on the other nodes. So basically your image has to be kept as small as possible, right? So in keeping all that in mind, so you have to keep your Docker image, just one image should have one application, right? So if you try to break that rule, then things get slightly more complicated, and that's also not the way you are supposed to use a Docker. Okay, so with this, I'll leave it here. So maybe we'll see, when I find time, I'll try to create more videos. Hope this was useful. Thank you.